Well, we all stand here with leaden hearts and insufficient words. You all know that Tom was shot last night in his home. Our thoughts and prayers are with his wife, Lisa, and their two daughters. Certainly with all the employees of the Department of Corrections who Tom worked so hard with. Tom's family has requested privacy at this time, and we sincerely ask the community and the media to respect that request. You can imagine this is the hardest time that anyone could possibly go through. They are grieving as we are all grieving. We lured Tom away. He was retiring as the number two guy at corrections in Missouri after 31 years. He was far and away the best choice we could find anywhere in the country. He understood the importance of building a team and operating an enterprise where your staff is motivated, focused. He understood the importance of making sure that as you released prisoners, especially those who had been incarcerated for extended periods, that the better job you did at preparing them for returning to the community, job training, making sure they had medication if they had mental illness, that this dramatically would decrease the chances of them being reincarcerated. You know, he first turned us down, was going to go to another state, and then upon reflection came to Colorado, and we are so grateful for the time that he gave us. He was a dedicated, committed, funny, caring expert at corrections. He had a sense of humor that all of us, you almost can't describe it, but his sense of timing when he would let a zinger fly was so unpredictable and yet so astute. He was a great friend to me, to I think all of us. In many ways, he helped define what a public servant is. He did his job quietly and intently. He cared deeply about his staff, his family, and the community. In his approach to corrections, he was all about best practices and using data and information to continuously improve the way we do things. How do we make our prisons safer, not just for the employees, but for the inmates? How do we do a better job of preparing inmates for returning to the community? His unfailing good nature would come through in everything he did, and the depth of his caring about, again, not just the people he worked with, but the inmates that were there, about those of us here that he worked with, was remarkable. When I first interviewed him, we talked about what was called administrative segregation. I'd had an old friend whose son had gone on the wrong track and been arrested and put into administrative segregation for a long period of time. This is, you know, solitary confinement. At that time, we had a very large number of people in administrative segregation. And part of that interview was Tom had thought deeply about it before he ever came to interview with us in his own experience in Missouri, and saw how it was doomed to failure, that number of people, and in many cases, people who had been in administrative segregation and solitary confinement for years would be released directly into the community, which is a very, for those individuals, really emotionally traumatic. And he laid out a plan by which to analyze the issue, get what the facts were, and make sure that we moved in the right direction, that we segregated those people that were a danger to other prisoners or staff, but that we begin that a more active rehabilitation on a large number of the others that were in administrative segregation for other, in many cases, not sufficiently important reasons. Tom was an unfailing partner in the repurposing of Fort Lyons, the prison we closed a couple years ago. He saw the impact of that facility on the community. He was committed to making sure that we did everything possible to try and put that building back to good use. He was so dedicated to his staff, and he would have town hall meetings at the various prisons around the state on a regular basis. He would ask in those meetings almost always, how do we uplift staff? How do we help our staff do a better job, but also how do we uplift them and make their days better and easier? Tom Clements dedicated his life to being a public servant, to making our state better, to making the world a better place, and he is going to be deeply, deeply missed. Questions? Yeah. I can't hear you. There's too much. Say it a little louder, please. Not that I know of, but I mean, it's an active investigation, so we can't talk about the investigation, but we don't know anything at this point, or enough to answer that kind of a question. We are certainly going to, as we get information about this, we will make sure that that our cabinet members are safe and that everyone is that we anticipate every possible eventuality. I don't think this, at least what little we know, was something that was directed at the cabinet. Corrections is a very difficult job. You make difficult decisions all the time that affect different people. You know, an incident like this, in some ways, whether it's an act of retaliation for something that as yet we don't know about, it is also an act of intimidation. And my gut feeling, and I think the cabinet is good with this, that we go forward with our work. That's the kind of thing Tom would have understood, I think. and would have supported. So we expect to sign the bills and answer questions and try to continue to move this state forward. No. No. He was supportive, but he was not particularly active. I don't think it will. I mean, Tom Clements was such a remarkably talented individual at getting things done and figuring out solutions to problems. I mean, he just was by nature a problem solver. So can we continue all the work that he was doing as fast as he was doing it? Perhaps not. But we're not gonna consciously slow down. We'll certainly not stop. He would expect no less. A couple more? No more. Oh, last night at, I don't know what time it was, maybe 9:30, I think, 9:30 or 10. It's a long night. We're going to leave directly from here and go down to spend time with his family and his staff. We hope so. You know, I think when you're in the middle of one, and this is the hardest thing for me, when you're in an active investigation, the less said, the better. And you never know when you say something that inadvertently, you know, somehow slows down the processes that law enforcement's going through. So I'm going to avoid commenting. But anyway, thank you very much.